I think it's very important for the legal professional, generally speaking, whether it is advocacy or judiciary, to hear from the market what they are view when it has come to the dispute resolution, what is the current struggling issue, what's the recommendation, what has been done so far. So the service of judiciary can be done better way by solving the problem, analyzing the problem, and come up with a new solution to build and rebuild the trust in the market generally in this region when it has come to the construction dispute.
As a dispute resolution lawyer who practices in arbitration, it sounds odd for me to say or to be advocating less formal disputes. But I think one of the features that we see is where parties are so entrenched and they're so at war that it's not healthy for anyone's business. Because as a result of that, there's a huge, it's the cost, it's the time, it's the fact that that takes away management time, and guys who should actually be building projects are taken away to be witnesses and to remember what they did 3-4 years ago. And I think to the extent that we can collectively as a community help to make a positive impact to actually look at resolving issues early, trying to make them less confrontational. You know, a lot of the times we see the correspondence, they write to each other, it's hugely aggressive, it's far too long, etc. So one of the other things we do is to try and come in and sort of look at contract administration practices as well, and to sort of help create best practice as to how those contracts are managed. And I think if you do a number of those things, you seek to try and avoid the hugely adversarial sort of fight or war at the end of the day.
At a time where the GCC markets absolutely need to be attracting inward investments, you know, we need to be delivering products in an projects in an efficient way, sending a message out to the investor community that this market is operating professionally, ethically, projects will be delivered on time and on budget, and therefore come and invest. And I think this is why we haven't seen major uptake in sort of PPP type delivery models, or indeed overseas investment coming in. And that's what we need. So again, I think the dispute resolution and avoidance of issues escalating to these major amounts of claims that we're seeing is an absolute must.
I think enforcement. Enforcement, to me, people get claims or disputes for different reasons. Sometimes one or other party simply doesn't want to agree because it's not good for them long term. In other cases, there's a genuine dispute that people simply cannot agree on. Once you've gone through the arbitration process, you get a decision. Again, if one party doesn't want to pay, there's an appeal process. You then go off into the court. There's another process for enforcement, so on and so forth. And these periods are after you've already been deliberating past the end of the job for a significant period of time. I think it's just continued uncertainty that it's the same in the UK. It's not a problem that's specific to the Gulf. I see the same issue of people having the opportunity to avoid a final settlement being too broad. And I think that's something that as a single point I think could be addressed.
The UAE have done good things, but there is a lot of things has to be done in a short course. When it has come to the education of judges, has been set up some special tribunal, some special education for judges to solve construction dispute. We have so far arbitration law in UAE to solve the arbitration problem in the past, and to give a better solution for when it has come to construction arbitration. But still, there is a lot of things need to be done comparing what has been done so far in this region, especially the adjudication problem. We have to come up with an adjudication system to solve the construction dispute.